Thank you for visiting the Coin Lady channel again. Guys, in this video, I want to talk to you about several reasons here in a short, concise, and easy to understand format. In the vast world of finance, where CEOs of RTX are talking about the XRPL having a potential 50 trillion coming to it in the next few years, the word Ripple keeps popping up. That's good, because as XRP holders, we feel like we have the winning ticket. The only thing I ever ask is that you hit the like button, spread the word, and leave a comment letting me know if you enjoy discussing XRP and other great digital assets. Share the truth about the digital revolution with the world. First things first, folks, XRP drops. If you want to be the first to know when Ripples are released, follow him on X, previously Twitter. Chris Larson has been appointed to the position of member of the IMF's High-Level Advisory Committee on Technology and Finance. Riding the wave of all these waves is one of 13 members who are exceptionally qualified, well-respected leaders in the financial and technological industries. Larson, Chris, thanks to Christine from the IMF, we should expect a beautiful market run in the second half of this year. Every indicator, particularly those based on historical cycles, points to a big run in the market in the second half of the year. Spot ETFs in Hong Kong are already live, and we learned today that Australia is also planning to introduce Bitcoin ETFs this year. Now that this has set off a chain reaction, the market is going to experience a deluge of volume. Since no one can stop talking about Ripple, I'd like to know who the top player in this market is that plans to attack multiple markets at once: the stablecoin market, the cross-border payments market, and the crypto custody market. My guess is that it's Ripple. A representative from Tether expressed their hope that the Ripple's team will have even greater success with their stablecoin in the future. In response, SDT released a statement claiming that Tether is unconcerned with the use of USDT in the US and Europe. Let me repeat. USDT is uninterested in or wants nothing to do with business. Meanwhile, that's totally okay in the US. I'm cool with that because I think Ripple will buy a bunch of it. Curiously, though, Ripple is also active on a global scale. Looking into Ripple's approach, we can see that it has been to work with major international banks to facilitate the transfer of funds over the globe. Having said that, know that they can and do handle retail money transactions as well. However, there is one participant in retail money that is often overlooked: Stellar. Mr. Man, Stellar CBDC rails are essential in the growth of CBDCs in Southeast Asia, especially Indonesia. The CBDC development and Southeast Asia have long been impacted by Stellar's pivotal role. Their location on multiple continents is known to us. We know that Franklin Templeton is working closely with several countries out there. They have an upgrade for institutional investors called the Binji token. 330 million men tokenized their choice of Brilliant, and now look at this. Ripple has completely swallowed Medico. In the custody industry, they will be unrivaled. As we spoke with you lately, they are collaborating with hundreds of institutions and have 1,700 non-disclosure agreements. This means they will dominate and even span borders. These banks will not require pre-funding, according to Brad. Why? For the simple reason that XRP and their technology are the panacea, dude. Returning to the previous point about Chris Larson, they are currently associated with the most powerful and influential people in the world, including the World Economic Forum, who decide our fate regardless of how much we like it or not. I don't know about the rest of you, but if we are going to be teammates, I want to be on the squad that comes out on top. Ripple and Stellar, in my opinion, are completely dead. These two companies are experiencing rapid, unmanageable growth. We are witnessing their collaboration with industry heavyweights. We can see them chatting with high-ups. Things like this don't happen by chance. We know that Ripple is part of the Bank of International Settlements Task Force. Just so happens to have been in the works for quite some time. Ripple and Stella are in an ideal situation, but I think their fate has already been decided. Lots of people are getting out of the market as they feel the heat, and we're witnessing it all fall apart right before our eyes. Here we are witnessing a minor drawback. Simple economics tells us that amps and previous cycles tell us what's going to happen later this year, with the demand for Bitcoin starting to tick away as supply decreases and the markets are about to flare up in a big manner. Additionally, we have individuals like Brad Garlinghouse, CEO of Ripple, who has publicly stated that we will experience a doubling of our size this year. A prediction that he has, in my opinion, spot on. Well, that concludes our video. Your support in the form of a like and a subscription would mean the world to me. Coming up shortly, farewell.